Jazallahu bil khayrati anna a'immatan lana naqalu al-Qur'ana 'azban wa salsala faminhum budurun sab'atun qad tawasatat sama' al-'ula wal-'adl zuhran wa kummala.
Now inshallah ta'ala I'm going to go into at-ta'lif fi 'ilm al-qira'at. The books that have been written in 'ilm al-qira'at. When I say inshallah ta'ala that I want to speak about the books that have been written in ilm al-qira'at, what I mean by that is kafan al-mustaqil, as a subject and a science, ilm al-qira'at, the works that have been written in it. I'm not referring to the books that have spoken about issues related to qira'at, like the kitab al-fada'il by Abu Ubaid Qasim al-Sallam rahimahullah, or the kitab ta'wil mushkil al-Qur'an, written by Ibn Qutayba, or Masahif by Sijistani, Abu Dawood, Ibn Abi Dawood Sijistani, rahimahullah, or Akhlaq Hamalat al-Quran, written by Al-Imam Al-Ajurri, rahimahullah, or Tafsir al-Thawri, or Ma'ani al-Quran lil-Farra, or Ma'ani al-Quran lil-Akhfash, or Tafsir al-Nasai, or Kutub al-Sihah, Bukhari, Muslim, or even the Al-Masanid, Musnad al-Imam Ahmed, and what he mentioned in there, or Sunan Abi Dawood and Tirmidhi ibn Majah al-Nasai. I'm not referring to that, or Kitab Sibawi, or even the Kitab Al-Muqtadab, written by Al-Mubarrad. Al-Mubarrad is the Shaykh of Al-Zajjaj. All of these scholars, they tackled issues related to Ulum Al-Qur'an, without a doubt. And there are mabahith, there are segments, and there are chapters where you take from it Ulum Al-Qur'an, Qira'at, and issues related to it. Because in our previous episode, I spoke about how ilm al-qira'at enters many other sciences. When I say at-ta'lif fi ilm al-qira'at, the books that have been written in ilm al-qira'at, I'm speaking about as a kafan mustaqil, an independent science. Okay? As an independent science. So, as an independent science that stands by itself, that has its dawabid, has its qawa'id, has its structure. The scholars have categorized the books that have been written in it in three types. The first one is Al-Kutub Al-Mufrada liqira'ati imam min a'imma, a book that has written in a particular qari or a particular imam from the Qurra. So you find a particular qari is being spoken about here, like Hafs and Asim, for example. This book only talks about this. So some kutub al-qira'at, that's how it is. It's specific to a qari from the Qurra. The second type of books that have been written in ilm al-qira'at is kutub which are called al-qira'at al-muwassa'ah. It doesn't have in there only one qari, but it has more than that, which we're going to mention, either 7, 8, 5, 2, or ma ila dhalik. And the third type is kutub, which are considered tawjihul qira'at. They explain the variations and the reasoning behind the qira'at. So those are the three types of books that have been written in ilm al-qira'at. Who was the first person who wrote in ilm al-qira'at? Scholars, they differed amongst themselves. One scholar, Ibn Atiyah rahimahullah, in the muqaddimah of his tafsir, he said that the first person who wrote it is Yahya ibn Ya'mar. And Yahya ibn Ya'mar, he died the 90th year of the Hijriyah. So if it is true that Yahya ibn Ya'mar was the first person to write in ilm al-qira'at, then ilm al-qira'at was written in the 90th year of the Hijriyah. That was when it first written kafan mustaqil, as an independent science. And that's very early. But I haven't seen anyone mention that other than Ibn Atiyah in his muqaddimah of his tafsir. And even when he mentioned it as ruwiya bi sighat al-tamrid. It was narrated that Yahya ibn Ya'mar had written a book in Qira'at. That's what he said. He said it was narrated, يعني بصيغة التمريض. And when I looked up the tarjama, the biography of Yahya ibn Ya'mar, I haven't come across anyone whatsoever who actually said that Yahya ibn Ya'mar has a kitab in qira'at. So that's a point to keep in mind, inshallah ta'ala. But what is famous and is mashhoor in the Ahlul Fan? What is famous and common amongst the ulama of qira'at, that is the first person who wrote in qira'at, is Abu Ubaid Al-Qasim ibn Salam, rahimahullah, who died in the year 224 Hijriah. That he is the first person who wrote it. And that's the most famous opinion amongst the ulama. ولذلك الإمام الجزري رحمه الله, he said that فكان أول إمام, the first imam, معتبر, who's taken into consideration, جمع القراءات, who combined قراءات, is Abu Ubaid Al-Qasim ibn Salam, was the first person who wrote in this science. And he said imam معتبر, an imam that's taken into consideration, the first person is Abu Ubaid Al-Qasim ibn Salam, rahimahullah. And as I said, Abu Ubaid Al-Qasim ibn Salam died the year what? 224 Hijriah. And he then said that Abu Ubaid Al-Qasim ibn Salam, when he wrote his kitab in Qira'at, the Qurra that he brought inside there were 25. 25 Qurra. In the 25, of course, is the 7 Qira'at, the 7 Qurra that we have in the kitab Hurud al-Amani wa Uchwa al-Tahani fi al-Qira'at al-Saba', which we will mention inshaAllah ta'ala soon. So according to the most prominent, the most famous opinion to the people of Qira'at or the scholars of Qira'at, is that Abu Ubaid al-Qasim al-Salam was the first person to write in al-Qira'at. So this opinion that says Yahya ibn Ya'mar seems very weak. Maqatib al-Sulayman also seems very weak, that opinion. Al-Imam al-Kisa'i also seems like a very weak opinion. And anyone other than that, the strongest, according to the scholars of Qira'at, is that the first person who wrote in this science is Abu Ubaid al-Qasim al-Salam. But the issue is, we don't have his works, Abu Ubaid al-Qasim al-Salam. And it's mafqood. For now, we don't have it. It's lost. It's from the works that we don't have, which are lost. So, what is the earliest work that we have? The earliest work that we have is an imam known as Abu Bakr ibn Mujahid, rahimahullah. He wrote a kitab called Kitab As-Sab'a fi al-Qira'at. He wrote a book called Seven in Qira'at. And this kitab, Abu Bakr ibn Mujahid wrote, he made the Qurra into seven. And scholars have discussed why he did that. Some scholars, they said he did it tabarrukan wa tayammunan. He did it tabarrukan. He wanted to get barakah from the hadith al-ahruf al-sab'ah. Because the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, unzila al-Qur'anu ala sab'ati ahrufin, that the Qur'an came down in seven ahruf, seven dialects. Ibn Mujahid wanted to follow the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in that. So what he did was, he wrote the qira'at in seven. Now the qira'at and the ahruf, are they one and the other? Are they the same thing? What is the relationship between the two? Again, don't worry about that. We will come to it inshallah ta'ala. But what we need to understand is, Abu Bakr ibn Mujahid wrote a book in which he called it Kitab al-Sab'ah. He has seven Qurra. In this seven Qurra book he has, he confused many people based on that. How did he confuse them? Because he called his kitab As-Sab'ah in Qira'at, so many people assumed that the kitab As-Sab'ah of Abu Bakr ibn Mujahid is actually the same as the seven ahruf that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was talking about. And they thought this is one and the other, and it confused so many people, and scholars discussed that. But we will leave that discussion for when we speak about what al-ahruf al-sab'ah actually means. Abu Bakr ibn Mujahid, rahimahullah, he passed away after he authored his book, a scholar by the name of Al-Husayn ibn Uthman al-Baghdadi, who died the year 378 Hijriya. He came and he wrote a book in Qira'at. And after that came Al-Imam Ali al-Dharqutni, rahimahullah, who died the year 385 Hijriya, who also wrote after Abu Bakr ibn Mujahid and after Al-Husayn ibn Uthman al-Baghdadi. After those came Abu al-Fath Uthman ibn Jinni, who died in 392 Hijriya, who also wrote in Ilm al-Qira'at. So what we have is, we have Abu Ubaid Qasim al-Salam, who died in 224 Hijriya. His book in Qira'at, we don't have it. After him came Abu Bakr ibn Mujahid. Abu Bakr ibn Mujahid died in 324 Hijriya. After him came Al-Hasim ibn Uthman, Al-Husayn ibn Uthman al-Baghdadiyu. And after him came Al-Imam Ali al-Dharqutni, rahimahullah. And after him came Abu al-Fath ibn Uthman al-Jinni, rahimahullah. May Allah have mercy upon all of them. So when it was Al-Qarn al-Khamis, the 5th century, great scholars came out and they authored. I'm going to mention two great scholars who writ in Ilm al-Qira'at the 5th century. Makki ibn Abi Talib, rahimahullah, who wrote a kitab called At-Tabsirah fi al-Qira'at al-Sab'ah. And Abu Amr al-Dani, rahimahullah, who wrote his kitab At-Taysir fi al-Qira'at al-Sab'ah. When the 6th century came, two great scholars also wrote in Ilm al-Qira'at, Abu al-Ala al-Hamadani, rahimahullah, and Al-Imam al-Shatibi. Abu al-Ala al-Hamadani wrote a kitab called Al-Ghaya fi al-Qira'at al-Ashr. So he made it 10. And Al-Imam al-Shatibi, Abu al-Qasim al-Shatibi, he wrote his kitab Hirzu al-Amani wa Wajhu al-Tahani fi al-Qira'at al-Sab'ah. And this kitab, Hirzu al-Amani wa Wajhu al-Tahani fi al-Qira'at al-Sab'ah, that Al-Imam al-Shatibi wrote, it's a nazm, a poetry form of the kitab al-Taysir, written by Abi Amr al-Dani, rahimahullah. ولذلك he says, وَفِي يُسْرِهَا التَّيْسِيرُ رُمْتُ اخْتِصَارَهُ. He said that this book, it's a summary of the kitab al-Taysir al-Imam al-Shatibi, Abi Amr al-Dani. That this kitab is a summary of the kitab written by Abi Amr al-Dani called At-Taysir. And Shatibi saying that. And then he also mentioned that it's not just a summary of it and a conclusion of it, but rather he's going to add some benefits and some fawaid here or there. He says, وَأَلْفَافُهَا زَادَتْ بِنَشْرِ فَوَائِدِي. And in some places he's going to sprinkle some benefits for us, which he did. If you look at the book, حرز الأماني وجو التاني في القراءات السبع. A lot of places, he makes dua, he gives reminders, he gives a heart-softening point, and the beneficial things he mentions. ولذلك الإمام الشاطبي, what is actually amazing is that he didn't only just make poetic form of the kitab التيسير in the science of قراءات written by Abu Amr al-Dani. He also made a poetry on another kitab written by Abu Amr al-Dani. He did the same to that as well, called Al-Muqni'. Abu Amr al-Dani has a kitab called Al-Muqni', and this kitab Al-Muqni' is published, walillah alhamdu wal minna, it's matbu' fi mujalladain, in two volumes. In this kitab Al-Muqni', it talks about Rasm al-Mushaf. Okay, the Rasm al-Mushaf. Al-Imam al-Shatibi came and he also made a poetry on that one. He called it Aqilatu Atrab al-Qasaid. And he did the same thing to that one. He added benefits in there as well, reminders and etc. So, Al-Imam al-Shatibi's kitab, Hirzu al-Amani wa Wajhu al-Tahani, was written in the 6th century of Islam. The 7th century, a scholar by the name of Ali ibn Muhammad al-Sakhawi al-Alamuddin, Abu al-Hasan, whose kunya was Abu al-Hasan. And don't confuse this Sakhawi with the student of Ibn Hajar al-Sakhawi. That one is called Shamsuddin al-Sakhawi, who wrote the kitab Fathul Mughith, which explained the kitab Alfiyatu al-Iraqi, the teacher of Ibn Hajar. So the student explained the teacher's book. Don't confuse it with that Sakhawi. This Sakhawi is before all of that. His name is Ali ibn Muhammad al-Sakhawi. His laqab, his nickname is Alamuddin, and his kunya was Abu al-Hasan. He wrote a kitab called Fathul Wasid fi Sharh al-Qasid, where he actually explained Hirzul Amani wa Wajhul Tahani fi al-Qira'at al-Sab'a. And his explanation is the first explanation on the Manzumat al-Shatibiyah that we have today. It's the first actual explanation on it. So that was written in the 7th century, where he went in details explaining it. But it's actually not the best explanation. I'm going to point out that the best explanation out, even though time doesn't allow it, and I would have compared the explanations, but the best explanation is Siraj al-Qari, written by Ibn al-Qasih. Ibn al-Qasih sharah is the best sharah of the kitab Hirzul al-Amani wa Wajhul Tahani fi al-Qira'at al-Sab'a. It's the best sharah. But it's not the earliest explanation. The early explanation is this one, Fathul Wasid fi Sharh al-Qasid. And the easiest and the most summarized and the most basic explanation of the kitab Hirzul al-Amani wa Wajhul Tahani is the Al-Wafi by Abdul Fattah al-Qadi. Abdul Fattah al-Qadi's sharah on the Hirzul al-Amani wa Wajhul Tahani is very basic, it's easy. A beginner can take that from a teacher. In the 9th century, Shaykh al-Muqri'in, Ibn al-Jazari came, rahimahullah, and he wrote an amazing book called Al-Nashr fi al-Qira'at al-Ashr. This kitab is, mashallah, matbu', it's mutadawal, it's 5 volumes, and it's with the tahqiq of Ayman al-Suwayd, with the tahqiq of Ayman al-Suwayd, hafidhahullahu ta'ala. This kitab, Al-Nashr fi al-Qira'at al-Ashr, Ibn al-Jazari rahimahullah wrote his final and last opinions in this field. And he had books before that where he spoke about things, like his Munjid al-Muqri'in and mentioned things there. But the kitab al-Nashr fi al-Qira'at al-Ashr is the final and last conclusion of Ibn al-Jazari rahimahullah. And what he did was, he made a nazm or poetry of this kitab, called it Tayyibatul Nashr. What's amazing is, the Tayyibatul Nashr has more Qurra than the Hirzul Amani. It's got 10. And it also has more Turuq than the Hirzul Amani. But it has less lines of poetry. And it's less lines of poetry. Whereas Hirzul Aman is 1,100 and something, this one's only 1,000 something. So Ibn al-Jazari summarized it more than Shatibi. But even then, Allah gave qabool and acceptance to the Hirzul Amani wa Wajhul Tahani. Why? Because of the way that Imam al-Shatibi's language and his the way he wrote it and the beauty in it. It's just something else, haqiqatan. I personally have never seen any Islamic science poetry that's written as beautiful as Hirzul Amani wa Wajhul Tahani. The beauty in it, it's just something else. Yani the eloquency in it, the structure that the Shaykh rahimahullah did it. All the other sciences you find, it's a bit rigid, it's a bit hard. But this one flows and smooth and it's so well presented, yani. Rahimahullah rahmatan wasi'a. So Tayyibatul Nashr is the poetic form of the kitab Al-Nashr fi al-Qira'at al-Ashr. ولذلك, a student of knowledge, when he wants to memorize the ilm al-Qira'at, he's advised to first of all memorize the Hirzul Amani wa Wajhul Tahani, which is the 7 Qurra that he mentions. Jazallahu bil khayrati anna a'immatan لنا نقل القرآن عذبا وسلسلا فمنهم بدور سبعة قد توسطت سماء العلا والعدل زهرا وكملا. And Shatibi mentions 7, and he mentions for each of those Qurra, he mentions Rawiyani, 2 Rawis. Then Ibn al-Jazari came, and what he did was he wrote the kitab Ad-Durra. He did the same brought two rawi for three extra narrators, or three extra, sorry, qurra. Abi Ja'far, Ya'qub, and Khalaf. He added those three in there. Two rawis for both, each made it 10. So the student memorizes the Hirzul Amani wa Wajhu Tahani. Okay, then he goes for the Durra. Now he has the Qira'at al-Sughra. And then what he does is that he goes to the Tayyibatul Nashr, which has more than one rawi for every qari. This is now called the Qira'at, which is the Kubra. For that, there's a great scholar, Abdul Fattah al-Qadhi, rahimahullah. What he did was he emerged the two into one. He called it Al-Budur al-Zahira fi al-Qira'at al-Asharat al-Mutawatira min tariqay al-Shatibiyyati wal-Durrah. So what he did is he took the tariqa of min tariqay al-Shatibiyyati wal-Durrah. He took the Shatibiyya and the Durrah, emerged them, so the student can take that book and benefit from it. The Kitab al-Shatibiyya has many shuruh. As I mentioned, from the sharh was al-Fath al-Wasid fi sharh al-Qasid, written by Alamuddin al-Sakhawi. Also from the shuruh is the Kitab al-La'ali al-Farida by al-Fasi, Ibraz al-Ma'ani by Abi Shamat al-Maqdisi, Siraj al-Qari by Ibn al-Qasih, and al-Wafi by al-Qadhi. Lakin, as I said, the best sharh for it, without a shadow of a doubt, is the Kitab written, it's called the Siraj al-Qari by Ibn al-Qasih. Yani the sharh of Ibn al-Qasih is the best. Also, another kitab that a person should really look into and buy and have is them is the Tadkira by Ibn Ghalbun. The Tadkira by Ibn Ghalbun, rahimahullah. He has in there 8 qurra, and the kitab is very beneficial. It's recommended for the student to have. Ibn al-Jazari, rahimahullah, all of his works in Ilm al-Qira'at are books that it has become the reference point for all of the a'immah after Ibn al-Jazari. يعني صار عيال على Ibn al-Jazari. All the scholars that came after Ibn al-Jazari, they became dependent on Ibn al-Jazari. But those are the most common, the most famous books that were written. And it's very necessary, brothers and sisters, that you read these books and you study them to have an understanding of this science, ilm al-qira'at. These books give you a good understanding and ground you. Once you've studied these books and you've learned it from its people and the scholars of that field, then and only then is it wise for a person to read the works of the orientalists and what they have said. Because if you don't know what is for you, you will not be able to defend the correct path. You will not be able to respond to the doubts that are brought. So study these books, read them, go over them, and study them deeply. You find a lot of answers in there. But when we become ignorant of these books and we abandon them and we leave them, and all we read is what an orientalist wrote here, or a Christian wrote here, or even a modern day graduate from a particular university wrote here, and we depend on that book, this is, it shows the weakness of our studying and our learning. Those are the most prominent books that have been written. Those are the famous works that are out there for a person to study and read ilm al-qira'at.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. How can you do a 2-second action right now that will give you a share of the reward of everything we're doing on this YouTube channel? Simple. Like this video and click subscribe. Why? It will allow YouTube to recommend our videos to other users. And imagine the huge amount of reward that could be waiting for you on the Day of Judgment if you did that with a sincere intention of spreading the Deen of Allah. You'll be rewarded for every single person who benefits from one of our videos as a result of your like or subscribe. That's an easy 2-second action that you definitely don't want to miss out on. Do it now. Click like and subscribe, and don't forget to make that intention.